I was about to send out a search party.
Sorry, I had to confirm some things before coming to see you. As I suspected, the Order of Revan as it once existed is no more. A bit of a shame, really. The Revanites' pragmatism may have been anathema to the Sith, but there was something appealing about it.
You should know that I was made a Revanite.
After crossing Darth Arkous, I doubt your membership stands. Not that the Revanites of now resemble the group as you understood it. The Order of Revan, as it stands now, doesn't wish to change the Empire from within. It aims to destroy us completely, and the Republic along with us. I've not yet learned why or how, but Theron Shan might. He appears to be rather good at his job.
With ears in both camps, we'll be better off against whatever threat the Revanites pose.
I'm glad you feel that way. I admit I was concerned you wouldn't take to the idea. Was there anything else you wanted to discuss?
I think I'm starting to warm up to you, Lana.
Is that right? You should know that the feeling's mutual. I have to go now. There's much yet to uncover about the Revanites' plans and the formation of this infinite army of theirs. I'll be thinking of you. Glad to see you again, as always, but I'm afraid any further niceties will have to wait. I know I've mentioned before a strange disturbance within the Force, a sort of writhing mass tied to Darth Arkous. I thought I'd use my connection to Arkous to seek out others tied to the disturbance, Revanites working against us from within. I found a few.
Give me names. Last thing any of them will ever see will be blaster fire.
I appreciate the offer, but we can't go placing bounties on embedded Revanites. Not yet, anyway. Theron Shan helped me decipher coded messages between the Revanites. Due to interference on Manan, they've accelerated their schedule.
Now they know they're up against us. Who could blame them?
Darth Arkous is intelligent, manipulative, and immensely powerful. We mustn't get overconfident. There's another way to stop Arkous. Theron's traced his activities to Rakata Prime. He and Colonel Darok are building their infinite army. And there's more. The implants they're using, they're made from pieces of the Starforge.
The Starforge? There was a machine on Nar Shaddaa that was built from it.
I'd heard rumors. It required virtually nothing to create almost anything. That was the Starforge's power as well. The Starforge was a Force-imbued, self-sustaining shipyard, Rakatan. It was destroyed centuries ago, but the Revanites have recovered some of the wreckage. Its technology makes the soldiers nearly immortal, seizes their minds as well, placing them under the Revanites' full control.
Gonna put that immortality part to the test, then see how Arkous and his Republic friend do. We're taking a trip to Rakata Prime. I'll drive.
No need, Hunter. I have a shuttle ready and waiting right here. Theron and Jakara are waiting for us planetside. The sooner we depart for Rakata Prime, the better.
Jakaro, D4.
Harrow! Spare at least a modicum of respect.
Hey, we're set to move on the Temple of the Ancients when you are.
That's the traitor's base of operations.
Yeah, the Rakata designed the Star Forge in that temple thousands of years ago. Now it's Arkous and Darok's grunt factory.
Theron and I will be monitoring your progress from Jakaro's ship. We'll assist you as we can, keep you apprised of matters.
You what? Jakaro, I agreed to no such thing. Wait, was this the talk with Agent Shad you powered me down for?
I should warn you, it's a rough road to the temple. The area's lousy with tribal Rakatans more than happy to fight. Found that out the hard way.
Wonderful! We're all going to die! Wonderful!
Remain focused and all will be well. I'm sure of it. We'll be in touch soon.
And straight through Rakata Central. Sorry.
Thank you. knows you're here. I'd say he sensed your presence, but I imagine it's all the commotion. He and Colonel Darok have shored up defenses outside the temple with their new conscripts. You know what to do.
Monitoring Revanite chatter. Somewhere near you, they discovered a hidden store of Rakata weapons. See that they don't get the chance to use them. army conscripts. They're further along with production than we suspected.
And open a channel there. I'll be able to slice into their systems remotely.
According to the structural plans, the only way to get at the head Revanites is through that conscription center.
The cyborgs are dormant for now, but they're set to go on high alert once they detect you. The console overload will fry them from the inside. Nope. Can't work the power safeties from here. You'll have to do the honors.
A sound plan. Theron, why can't I get this sensor to work?
Because Jakaro isn't a big fan of upkeep. Probably a dead relay. I'll check it out.
That he's gone, might I recommend not doing as Theron suggests?
An overload would destroy the data as well. The Empire might want its own infinite army someday. You would have to fight those cyborgs, but...
There goes any concern of you getting too cozy with a Republic spy.
Make no mistake, I serve the Empire.
And the Empire serves me cash. So let's try it your way.
Hey, what happened? Why is the console still running?
We couldn't make it work. The room will have to be traversed the hard way.
Are you sure? What did you try?
Everything.
If you say so. Hey, those sensor relays were fine, by the way. Not sure what the problem is.
Was. The sensor appears to be working again.
Yeah. escape. Looks like they've got a shuttle. We can shoot it down if we have to, but I'd rather take them in for questioning if you can. Hurry.
Wishes to confront the men who betrayed him and left us for dead. As would I, actually.
Come on, then.
We Revanites went through a great deal of trouble to reach this point in our campaign. For you to hamper our progress, it's regrettable. You, Lana, you were never anything more than pawns to us. Important pawns, but pawns all the same.
This is the part where you give up and tell me everything, Arkous. Everything.
So, this is where I outline our grand design, and then you decide whether or not to spare my life? This grotesque alien beast does have it partly figured out. Indeed, I won't cooperate, but I'm not fleeing. We will stand our ground and put an end to your perpetual interruption. Colonel?
Could see what we were doing, what we want for the galaxy. But you can't see. You'll just have to die.
We're finishing this, here and now.
I can't wait.
You've come too far to submit now. I have you now!
Sweet vengeance!
They're yours, Darok! You have them, Arkous! Dead! You've changed nothing! You have them, Arkous! You've changed nothing! They're yours, Darok! Beyond any of you. You gotta do better than that. We will save the galaxy! You should have just walked away!
No. The plan!
You think you'll walk away from this? Impossible! It can't be!
Arkous and Darok were never going to be taken alive. They were never going to talk.
I felt Darth Arkous's passing. This is an unfortunate turn.
Yes, you did. What a relief.
Blast it, those two were running the show. They were our best hope of exposing the Revanites.
No, they weren't in charge. The disturbance in the Force, I still feel it. It's arrived.
Got company. Ships, capital-sized, whole bunch of them. Can't tell if they're yours or ours, but one of them's dropping in to visit.
As important as Arkous and Darok were to the cause, their deaths won't stop us. They won't even slow us down.
That voice. I've heard it before.
It's Revan.
I almost had the Infinite Army I wanted so badly. But even without them, I have enough.
I watched you take your last breath and say your last words.
Oh, I was dead. For all of a blink. I've been reborn. My mind is clearer. My power intensified. And now, with the Order under my command, I'm unstoppable.
You're telling me the Revanites weren't always under your control?
At first, I wanted nothing to do with them. I was no prophet. Then I saw them in a new light. A secret group of devotees waiting to follow my lead without question. To help me save the galaxy. I was a fool to ever disregard them. I finally let the Revanites into my world. A world you have to be erased from.
Turbo lasers are locking on! Get out of there!
Can't reach your Jakaro ship. Take the shuttle.
Thank you.
You made it.
The way Revan was laying waste to that place, I wasn't sure you'd come out of it in one piece.
What are you talking about? I'm hardly in one piece.
Anyway, my point is, I'm glad you got out of there. Any ally right now is a welcome ally.
We took care of Arkous, Darok, and their infinite army. But where does that leave us?
It's a good question. Now that we know Revan's in the picture, everything changes. For the worse. In fact, it's already started.
Whatever do you mean?
I'll fill you in, D4. Come on, Jakaro. Let's give him a chance to talk. Lana, when you're done, we can start picking out backwaters to go lie low in.
Some good news. I was able to extract a good amount of data from the Infinite Army conscription console. Unfortunately, we can't possibly hand it over to our Imperial colleagues. The Revanites have just proven they're everywhere. Jakaro's had 12 death sentences declared on him. Theron's been disavowed by the SIS. And the Empire's placed a bounty on my head for the murder of Darth Arkous.
Any idea what they're paying? Maybe it'll be worth my while.
I suppose the upside is at least one of us is in a joking mood. At least I hope you're joking. What a mess. Our names can't be cleared unless we expose the Revanites. And we can't expose the Revanites without knowing who to expose. The way forward is clear. Theron, Jakaro, and I are going underground. We'll find a way to uncover Revan's plan and stop him.
You can't do it alone. You'll need me alongside you.
Like it or not, Hunter, the people of the Empire have come to see you as a hero. They need you. Be who you are, but be observant, and tell no one the truth about us or what you know. Above all, do not try to contact me.
I wish you didn't have to go.
It won't be easy for me either. Just know that I'll be thinking of you. All our fates ultimately rest in your hands. Remember that.